Hi students and welcome back to Bank Exams today. And in this video, we are going to discuss about the some important rules of conjunction that will help you to solve the error spotting questions, phrase replacement, and help you to understand the concept of English language, how the sentences are structured based on the conjunctions. Okay. So basically, conjunctions are a part of sentence that combines a sentence into a single entity or single thing, right? So in this video we are going to learn the 10 basic conjunctions that will help you to attempt the error spotting questions and phrase replacement as well as other English grammar questions. So we are starting with the because, as and since. These three words are used when the result comes before the reason. As we all know that because, as and since represents the result. When we are stating a result in a sentence, these three words are used. So, but when do we use it? When result comes before the reason. Like for example, crime is increasing in UP because there is no government in the state. Right? So, crime is increasing in UP. It means it is our result. And because there is no government in UP, and this is the reason. So result is coming before the reason. That's why we are using because. Then I drank a glass of water because I was thirsty. Here I drank a glass of water. This is our outcome or final conclusion. And I was thirsty is the reason that a person performed an activity, right? Similarly, since she started the journey, she has been feeling sick. So she has been feeling sick. She started the journey. The girl has just started the journey. This is the outcome of the process. The process is related to journey, and she is feeling giddy or something, like she is not feeling well during the journey. So this is the reason we are using since. And for example, you have to use as you know. Our mother is unwell, we will not be able to attend the school. So, as you know, the person already knows a thing, so we are using as in the beginning of the sentence. Clear? And the next is so and therefore. These two words are used when the result comes after and the reason comes before. For example, he served the security selflessly, so he got many awards. He got many awards is the result of his bravery, of his selfless duty, right? I was thirsty, so I drank a glass of water. So here, I was thirsty is the reason, and drinking water is the outcome of the activity mentioned before. So this is the basic difference between therefore and because. Now we are moving to these three words, because, since and as. When we use because, we are focusing on the reason. If in a sentence you want to focus more on the reason rather than the outcome, then you will use because. She spoke quietly because she did not want Catherine to hear. Now, the reason here is she did not want the other person to hear his voice or her voice. That's why she is speaking very quietly or very low, and that's why we have used because. Now, we often use as and since when we want to focus more on the result than the reason. If in a sentence you think that the reason is more important, the reason is not that important as the result is, so we use as and since. Like, we often use as and since clauses at the beginning of the sentences. Since everything can be done from home, here this is the result. The outcome is really important. With the computers and telephones, there is no need to dress up for work anymore. So this is the reason and this is the outcome. As everybody already knows each other, there is no need for introductions. There is no need for introduction is the reason, because the outcome is important as everyone is already acquainted to each other. Right? Now, the next is very simple, either and neither. Either means one out of two. It represents the choices in our life or something which is important for us, and neither is none out of two. Means nothing from the two things or two persons is picked or selected. Like, either she or you. Here we have two persons are to blame for the mismanagement of the domestic affairs. Here, any one of these two persons is accountable for the domestic affairs mismanagement. That's why we're using either. Either movie is interesting means there are two movies and from the two movies one is more interesting and the other is less interesting. And if we are talking about neither movie is interesting, there are two movies and none of them is interesting. Right? Then, in old age, neither of his two sons is prepared to come to his help. Now, here, there are two sons. And none of them is ready to help their mother or parents. Clear? Now we are moving to when and as long as. We use when as a conjunction meaning at that time. The clause with the when is subordinate clause and needs a main clause to complete its meaning. So here we should have two clauses, independent clause and subordinate clause to complete a sentence. Like, when he awoke to reality, all had been lost. When he awoke to reality or when he realized about the reality, he had been lost. When calamity befall the family, he faced it boldly. Here we are representing a time which is mentioned in the sentence, or we are mentioning that time of the to other person. We use as long as to refer the intended duration of a plan or idea. Means here the time period is not confirmed, so we are giving a rough idea of time period that is a thing or a person is going to take and which commonly refers to the future. Like, we are very happy for you to stay at our house as long as you like. So here the person is not really confirmed how long he will stay at a person's home. So, but the host is ready to keep that person as long as he like. It means the time period is not fixed and we don't know how long will it go. Clear? Then, I'll remember that film as long as I live. So I don't know how long I live, but I am going to remember that movie as long as I live. So there is no surety of time, no confirmation, no finite time period. So we are using as long as. Okay, so we are moving to no sooner than. This is a common problem among the students that when a sentence that has no sooner than comes in the error spotting or phrase replacement, they get confused. How can the helping verb be used before the noun or before the subject? But it is a clear rule in the English language that if you are using no sooner, then the helping verb will come before the subject. Like, no sooner did the thief see the policeman. It means no sooner the thief saw the policeman, then he ran away. Here we have used did, so we are not using saw as a second form of verb. Similarly here, no sooner was he brought here than he began to feel uneasy. If you are using no sooner in a sentence, don't forget to bring your helping verb before the subject, and then you have to use the than word after the subordinate clause or dependent clause. Clear? Then we come to hardly, scarcely, when and before. These words are often means something that happens not very commonly, not very easily, or not very generally in our life. We don't see such things happen and we use scarcely or hardly. Like in Hindi you can say mushkil se ya never. And this often focuses on the event which followed the other event. The verb describing the earlier event is usually in the past perfect. If we are using it in the following examples, then here hardly and scarcely both are used as the they are following the another they are followed by some other course of action. Like, hardly I left the house when it began to rain. It means the person has just stepped out of his house and it began to rain. It means just, as we use in the normal language. Hardly had I stepped out of my house when I saw some policemen coming towards my house. Okay, so here we are emphasizing that one event quickly followed the other. Like, he just stepped out of his home and the rain started. And the verb describing the earlier event is usually in the past perfect. So, the front or the beginning of the sentence will always have a past perfect tense. Hardly had I, hardly had they, hardly had we, something like this. Okay, now we are moving to though, although and even though. These, any one of these conjunctions are used when the sentence is in a subjunctive mood. It means that we are not really very sure about something or there is a doubtful condition, and it should always be followed by yet. When you are not confirmed about a thing, about a person, about a situation, then you use though, even though, although, and then the sentence is followed by yet. Like, even though she spoke to me rudely, yet I'll be polite to her. So, yet represents that I'll be polite to her is not confirmed. Rather, I will be rude to her also, or I will be polite. Clear? Although the students were allowed a 15-minute break, yet none of them left the room. So, students were given a 15-minute break, but they did not leave the room. It means that there was a doubtful condition among the students, so that's why they did not leave the room. Moving to the next part, this is such as and such that. Such as can be used with a noun to introduce examples. In a sentence, if you are referring to some example, then you can use such as, like fruits such as mangoes and grapes are rich in nutrients. And if you talk about the such that, it is a correlative conjunction. It is used to give reasons. In a sentence, if you want to give a reason, then use such that. For example, there are two sentences. Correlative conjunction means it just combines two sentences and make them a single entity. Like, it was a very cold afternoon, we stopped playing. There are two sentences, two different sentences, and if we have to use such that in a sentence, we will use it was such a cold afternoon. Here, such is representing the reason that we stopped playing, and we stopped playing is the conclusion. Okay. Now we are moving to same as and same that. Same as is used when two objects in two cases, and same that one object in two cases. I have the same laptop as you are using. A person, this is another person, and I am another person. We are using a laptop which is manufactured by the same company or same brand. So, two objects in two cases. I have my own laptop and the other person has his or her own laptop. But the brand is same. That's why I am using same as. And this is the same car that I saw yesterday. And the person is referring to the car that he saw another day or a day before yesterday. So he is referring to the same object in two cases. Now he saw the car yesterday and he is seeing the same car today only. Right? So he refers to the same. Clear? So students, these are the main 10 basic conjunctions that we have discussed in this video. I hope that you got a clear idea how we use this conjunction in the different kind of sentences. I am preparing some more videos on the same topic, and I hope you would like this video. And if you like this video, click the subscribe button, like my YouTube channel, and if you want daily updates, kindly install GK Digest Android app. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting.